like a, have you seen the kids playing with the playing cards? They will build big castles with the just playing cards. With playing cards, they will build castles. Have you seen? But kids are intelligent. They build their castles with their own cards. What do you do? We build our personality with other certificates. Just as the kids build their castles with playing cards, we build our personalities with others certificates. If somebody says you are obedient, we collect that idea. From the young age, we collected all the ideas of the society. Whatever others have said about us, if somebody says you are a good person, we collect that idea. If somebody says you are a very intelligent, we collect that idea. If somebody says you are smart, we collect. If somebody says you are dark, we collect. If somebody says you are beautiful, we get that idea. If somebody says you are not beautiful, we collect every idea. And totality of that idea, the plus minus, everything we put together, we come to an opinion about ourselves from the other's ideas. If we receive 10 opinions from 10 persons, we put together everything and create an idea about ourselves from these 10 opinions. Be very clear, because you do not know about yourself, you are not centered on you, you understand about you from others' opinion. There is a small research done by Chicago University, beautiful research. One day morning, early morning, young man is going to his office. When he came out of his house, the man was standing just in front of his house, asked him, "You look so tired. Why are you going to the office? Why don't you rest?" He said, "No, no, I'm quite okay. I'm all right." He went to the bus stop. In bus stop, there was one more person, one of his friend, asked, "You look so tired. Why don't you go and rest? Why should you want to go to office? Why do you want to go to office?" This man said, "No, no, I'm all right." In the bus again, one more friend said, this totally arranged, actually they arranged. One more person asked, "Hey, your face shows you are tired. Why don't you go and rest? Why do you go for a job?" Again he said, "No, no, I'm all right." He went to the office. In the office, ground floor itself, somebody said, receptionist, she said, "Why don't you have a leave and rest? Why don't you get your leave and rest? You look so tired." As soon as he went inside the office, boss called and told, You could have had your leave. You feel so sick. By seeing you, I can understand. You are tired. Are you sick? Why don't you go and rest?" The man really started thinking. And not only he started thinking, he applied for leave and went to the house. Went and is rested. That day evening, he had a temperature. Not only temperature, really is sick. When many people continuously tell you something, you immediately start believing. Not once or twice, 15 times they did this experiment. All the 15 percent fell sick. All the 15% fell sick. They just arrange some 10 people here or there casually to tell, "It seems you are not feeling well." The test proves how much others' opinions play on our mind. How much you live based on others' opinions. It's just like the castle built by other certificates. As the kids build their playing card castle, cards castle, you build your personality with the others' opinion, with the other certificates. How long you can have other certificate, tell me? As long as you dance according to their tune, you will have, they will let their certificate to be with you. How long you can dance according to everyone's tune? Imagine, one side your husband is playing Kathakali music, you go there and do few Kathakali step, and the other side daughter is playing pop music, you jump there and do few steps of pop, and back side your son is doing Bharatanatyam music, then you do few Bharatanatyam steps, this side somebody else is doing rock step, rock music, you jump there and do few rock steps, this side to that side to this side, this corner to that corner, here there, here there, if you continuously run around, what will be your dance? It will be nothing but mess. That is what now we are doing. Everybody has got their own tune. How long you can run, you can dance for everybody's tune. If you know 6-7 type of dances, at least you may manage. Even then I don't think you will be able to manage, because you need to shape, change the tune. How long you can manage? If you dance according to everybody's tune, then they will let their certificate to be with you. If you don't dance, if you don't dance according to everyone's tune, what will happen? They will take away their certificate. If somebody takes away their certificate, what happens to your personality? That's what I call depression. Continuously it happens. It's like you are a centipede. Centipede means you understand the with 100 legs. You have 100 leg. Only if all the 100 persons say something good about you, if all the 100 say some nice things about you, you feel comfortable. You can walk. If someone takes away their leg, what will happen to you? You just tumble down, collapse. I tell you, this is a homework which you need to do. Make a list of the people who can depress you. Now really, now this will give you the new understanding in your life. See, most of the time, we do not even know our problem. That is the problem. Once you know your problem, 90% of things gets dissolved. Once the problem is brought to the consciousness, you will see that it disappears. Find out who all can depress you, for whose opinions you wait. How many persons' opinions you give weight for them? How many persons' opinions you give respect? Who all can depress you? Make a list who all can depress you. Be very clear, you are slave of all of them, that's all. Understand very clearly. Just by one word they can put you into depression. You are slave of them. You see, psychological slavery is the worst thing any man can have. You are actually psychologically handicapped. Without them all, you cannot move your life. That is what it means. Make a list who all can depress you. Have it in your bedroom itself, so that every day you remember, I am slave of all these persons. At least let you be aware. As of now, what is there in your life? Same thing, let you be aware that you are slave of all of them. Once your being is aware that you are slave of them all, naturally you will come out of it. I tell you, very naturally you will come out of it. The being is such, your nature is freedom. It will never allow you to be slave of somebody. It will never let you be slave of somebody. So the very understanding, just make this list. You may think, oh, this all looks impractical. What type of solution this Swami is giving? But once you make this list and continuously see, at least for 10 days, every day when you see, you will automatically turn your maturity, or your mind will turn towards the maturity. You will never invest your energy on so many persons. Now you do not even know on how many persons you have invested your energy. It's like a bank. You have 100% energy, but you invested all your energy on so many persons. Only 10% you have, 10% of the energy you have. That is why you always feel low. You expect their attention to just boost you. You expect their pampering to bring you up. You always feel without them, you cannot move. Tell me.
Unfortunately, when somebody removes their attention, the tendency is to work harder to get it back.
No. Then again, you are working in the line of slavery. I tell you, by making this list, you will integrate yourself. And one more thing, you will be able to give love to others only if you are integrated. Till your integration, whatever you give is not love. It is just bargaining. You give your attention, I will give my attention. It's a contract, business. And like a begging bowl. My begging bowl eats your begging bowl is eats. It's my begging bowl. Both of them are standing in front of each other with a big begging bowl. All sound which you hear in your house is nothing but the clashes of these two begging bowls. He is asking for your attention, she is asking for his attention. Both are asking for others' attention and nobody is able to give. Once you understand you are slave of so many persons, you will understand you have invested your energy on all of them. Then you will be able to integrate. You may ask, then Swamiji, should we not live an adjusted life? I tell you, adjustment is different, compromising is different. Most of the time, you compromise, but you claim yourself as I am living a very adjusted life. Adjustment has nothing to do with compromise. What is adjustment? What is compromise? Let me explain. Compromise means you are not having your center. You are just having your center on so many persons. You are like a centipede. So you cannot do anything. You have to compromise. You are dependent on others. Your energy is dependent on others. Only by others' opinion you are alive. This is a compromise. Our present state. Adjustment means you totally integrate your energy in your being. You are never bothered or depressed by anybody's opinion. Even then, you bend and give your attention to others. Even then, you listen others' opinion. Even if you are not disturbed, you are ready to listen to others' opinion. That is what is adjustment. But in our being, 99% of us are wounds. We have a wound in our being. That is why we always compromise. We are never integrated. Understand, if you are integrated, you will adjust. Otherwise, whatever you do is compromising. Never live a compromised life. It is psychological slavery. Psychological slavery is much worse than physical slavery. And I tell you, only when you are integrated, only when you have energy on yourself, only when you are centered on yourself, you can really love others. You can really give your attention to others. Only then you can really adjust and live happily. Till that time, till the moment of centering yourself into the heart, whatever you do will be only a business. That is why always we say, almost all love marriage, I can say 99.9% love marriage, they feel the other has cheated you. Before marriage, he was one way, and after marriage, is the other way. Be very clear, nobody has cheated you. It is we who cheated ourselves. It is we who cheated ourselves. We always think that this is going to be this way and that is going to be that way. And we ask for continuous attention. Finally we say, we have not got it. He has cheated us. Nobody is cheated you. It is you who is cheated. Because how much you can dependent on other, you can be dependent on others. Each one has got their own dependency on others. As long as you are dependent on others, be very clear, you are not going to feel satisfied. You are not going to center yourself. There is a beautiful technique from Tibetan Buddhism to center your heart, to center your energy. Already we practiced this meditation one day in the New York. Now, this is the first technique, first level technique, a preliminary technique to center your energy. Then step by step, we will go into the next energy centers and work. Now, let us enter into the first level technique to center your heart, to center your energy. Before entering into the meditation, I want to spend a few minutes. Do you have any question about what we spoke now, what we discussed? I don't think every one of you understood everything, because I myself have not understood totally. Yes.
My question is, there are moments when we feel love without having an expectation. How is that different, or is it different?
The moments of meditation, you see, the moments of a deep spiritual level, the moments of meditation, if it has happened to your life, only then you will be able to feel the moments of love without any expectation. Till then, even if your mind says that I am not expecting anything, there will be something in the background, search. Then you will be able to find out. Only when you have the taste of pure love by meditation, only by meditation you can have the taste of pure love, the energy.